Dr. Jackson. Man, I'm stressing, man. It's too much going on. I'm seeing all these successful people. I don't even know if they believe.
Calm down.
I need to talk to somebody.
Well, you're in the right place. Have a seat. Now tell me, what's going on in your mind?
I think I'm going crazy.
Going crazy? Yeah, mental hospitalization. Don't mind him, he is my apprentice. Well, we're gonna count to seven. When I count to seven, I want you to close your eyes. And in the midst of closing your eyes, you're gonna wake up in a brand new state of mind. But you have to go through these visions in order to change yourself. Are you ready?
I'm ready, Doc.
All right, here we go. Let's start. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven.
For a bit of some queer, huh? But these nigga bitches let me deal, yeah. Ayy, holy do it. I ain't fall off, I just ain't release my new shit. I blew up, and everybody tryna sue me. You call me Nas, but the hood call me Doobie.
And this one is for the champion.
Track record so clean, they couldn't wait to just bash me. I must be getting too flashy, y'all shouldn't have let the world gas me. It's too late cause I'm here to stay and these girls know that I'm nasty. I sent her back to her boyfriend with my handprint on her ass cheek. City talking, we taking notes, tell him all to keep making posts. Wish he could but he can't get close. OG so proud of me that he choking up while he making toast. I'm the type that you can't control, said I would then I made it so. I don't clear up rumors, where's y'all sense of humor? I'm done making jokes cause they got old like baby boomers. Turn my haters to consumers, I make vets feel like they juniors. Say your time is coming soon, but just like Oklahoma, mine is coming sooner. I'm just a late bloomer. I done peak in high school, I'm still out here getting cuter.
Made you one cool. Thank you guys for joining us on another episode of the Not Your Average Success Story Movement. I have another dope guest that she it was crazy as I think she showed interest back on season four, and we're here. We finally got a chance to get her on. I'm pretty excited to see what she has to say. Would you like to introduce yourself? Name, interesting fact, where are you from?
Hi, I am Brittany. Most people know me by Nicole. I am from Meridian, Mississippi, and my interest. Ooh, that's a good one. I'll say helping people since I'm in the medical field.
Helping people, so that, I mean, that sounds more like an occupation. What's an interesting fact about you specifically? Like, what do you like to do? What type of food? Is there a specific type of food?
I'm picky.
You picky on food?
Like, very.
If you could choose one thing to eat, hey, I'm having dinner tonight, what would it be?
Ooh, collard greens.
Greens? That's gonna fill you up?
I mean, yeah, but like cornbread or something.
Okay. Are you cooking them or are you buying them?
Oh, I gotta cook them.
Okay,
you know,
okay.
Everybody can't make grits.
Everybody can't. That's why I asked. Okay. So, Nicole Brittany. I got a sister named Brittany Nicole. How do you... So, everybody calls you Nicole.
Yeah.
Your name is Brittany. Is that like a...
It's just like my family calls me that okay. a lot. So, Nicole is just like I respond to it quicker than I do
okay.
Brittany.
Okay.
Nobody calls me by my first name but my mom, but that's only if I'm in trouble, so...
I feel you on that. And you also said Mississippi. So for my Mississippi folks, hey, we got another one in the crib. How did you find your way to Nebraska all the way from Meridian, Mississippi?
My husband, he is in the military.
All right.
He actually just had an anniversary. So he served like 10 years.
Okay, okay.
For like a cool 5.
Wow, nice. Congratulations on that. Congratulations. So did you go to Meridian High School?
I did.
What was their mascot?
Wildcats.
And y'all had the blue. It was blue.
Yeah, I think it was like royal blue.
Listen, I ain't gonna lie. No shade.
Shade wrong.
Meridian was nice. Meridian, honestly, I don't remember. I don't know if that was a 4A or a 5A school. I don't know if it, do you remember?
I don't remember.
They was cold. I just didn't like them because we couldn't beat them. Like, I ran track and we were there. Pretty much that was our district meet. That's where our regional meet was held. So we really got to get into deep competition when it was time to go to Meridian. So
Of course.
Those guys. But man, cool. Well, we're just gonna kinda jump right into it. Is there something that you've had to overcome or something that you are currently overcoming that you don't mind discussing with us today?
Yeah, sure. What I'm currently overcoming, where should I begin?
I was just about to say, it could literally, I'm assuming you dealt with so much, like it could come from any angle.
Oh, where can I begin? Because I'm kind of like, as I'm starting, you know, from each angle, coming from my career, the whole military life thing, you know, kids, balancing school, all of that is just, it's hard, I can say that. So it's a lot of like hills and obstacles that I could honestly say that I will have to overcome, and I'm still learning, so I haven't really achieved that goal as of yet.
Okay. And is that like, so when you say the military life, because I didn't really understand it. I had a friend who grew up in the military. His mom, his dad was in the military, and so they traveled all the time. And to me, I grew up in one place for 18 years. And when he would tell me that he got a chance to travel all the time, to me, I'm thinking, bro, like, that's dope. You know, I grew up in one place, but you know, he described, he was actually on our first season, he described that he was never able to establish a place that he can call and feel comfort of home, because he was moved around so much. So it blew my mind that would even be something that someone would go through. I guess from your, and he's a guy, and then he was speaking from a kid's perspective, like I guess from a wife's perspective, what I guess what battles do you deal with as far as like being in the in a military family?
His job plays a major part. He's never at home, so like now he's getting ready to leave soon, so he's mostly gone. I say the most is 6 months. The least I can say is a month.
Okay. That's 30 days.
Yeah, I know. So it's just like, you know, once he's gone, you're automatically in the mode of being a single mom. You don't have that extra help.
Yeah.
So I like, this is not what I picture my life to be, you know? Yeah. It's like, one, I never wanted to be with a military man. No offense, honey.
Yeah.
No offense. Yeah. But that's just not what I actually had in mind as a husband. But now I should be there. Like I said, he's never home. So I'm taking care of the kids more, you know, juggling with school, because I'm currently still in. 2 more years, y'all.
Yeah.
But yeah, with that, it's just,
man.
It's tough.
Yeah. So how do you find a balance? Do you just cling to that day where it's like, okay, he will be back, or do you just suck it up and just deal with it?
I wouldn't say like suck it up. I mostly would just say like it's a routine.
Gotcha.
You know, it took me just last year to just stop crying every day and get with the process. So now it's just like, okay, I have to be an adult here. I gotta do it for my kids, you know, and not for all, I gotta do it for him. Because, I mean, with him, me crying helps him in the benefit. So, you know, I kind of really got a schedule going on. So, hey, I take care of the kids, get them bathed, feed, done, clean the house, boom. And then I go to school work, and then I'm up till like 1, maybe 12, 1 o'clock in the morning, getting that done, and, you know, routine, getting ready for work, and then I'm up. Like, it's a routine. It's definitely a routine, and I want to say it happens overnight, because like I said, I just now getting it up.
Honestly, shout out to those black women, man. I'm listening to you, like, describe this, and I'm thinking, man, my little life is a little stressful, but, you know, my little routine.
Yeah.
But, I mean, honestly, I think that's dope, and it's very mature, and it's, honestly, man, like, I don't know. I ain't gonna say that I wouldn't be able to do it, but you make it sound a lot easier than I'm assuming that it would be, and I think that, obviously, comes over time, comes with repetition, and obviously your support system, you know what I'm saying? So, shout out to you guys. That is amazing. I guess outside of the military perspective, does it kind of bleed over into, so when you become into a military, when you have a military family, is it just strictly military, or is it like military at a certain point and then normal life at a certain point?
I'd say a little both. Like, I feel like I have an on and off switch.
Yeah.
Like, once I'm in the military, like, well, family-wise, I switched on to that, because then I have to get on his level and understand what's going on. But outside of it, it's normal.
Mm-hmm.
So I just be myself with, you know, the little friends that I do have. But I guess it's like an off and on switch.
Off and on. Okay. Well, that, so I guess, what, 5 years from now.
Oh, boy.
What does it look like for you guys? Obviously, like I said, you're growing and maturing in it. Like, are you guys, like, wanting to, not to be in your business, but ideally, do you, like, see yourself traveling somewhere else? Do you see yourself moving somewhere else?
Actually, little birdie in the house, we were supposed to be moving to Florida.
Oh, shut up. Have you ever been?
I visit. I have family there.
Okay.
I'm kind of excited.
Yeah.
But, yeah, I'm pretty looking forward into that. Maybe hopefully 5 years from now.
Yeah.
Hopefully next year. No offense, Omaha. I love y'all.
Yeah.
I'm like, I'm ready for the scenery here.
Honestly, Florida is beautiful, and I think it's very therapeutic too. I want to be somewhere. I want to end up somewhere. I don't know where I'm gonna end up. I don't know where I'm gonna be, but I want to be near some water. Like, it's to me, listening to it, the sun, sand in my toes, like, that just, like, automatically makes me go,
yeah,
you know what I'm saying? Even I can think about it in the most stressful mindset, and then just going out there and just being able to look over that. I mean, I don't know, I may be weird to some people, that may be like, what is this guy talking about? But I've experienced it, so it's like, yeah, like, I would love to at least be able to have access to that.
Yeah,
it ain't out here in Nebraska, but shoot, man, was there something else that you kind of wanted to tap into as far as things that you've dealt with or currently dealing with?
Not at the moment.
That's perfectly fine. Any messages, any advice to any young women, any military wives, you know, that may have dealt with what you're dealing with, any advice that you would like to give them?
My advice to all the mothers out there, whether you're military or not, especially ones that doesn't have any kids, I just say, do your schooling, your traveling, enjoy your spouse a lot more before having kids. Unfortunately with me, I started early at the age of 21. So I didn't get that chance to meet my goals and my expectation at the timeline that I planned to. I just basically say, keep your heads up. For the ones that does have kids, it's not the end of the world. It does get hard, especially for myself. I have no support here. It's just me and my husband and two kids. So you can only imagine the pressure that could be on your shoulders. And for the ones that is doing it, you definitely understand the pressure that is on your shoulders. And again, it's not the end of the world. Just move at your own pace. You eventually will get there. It took me a little over 5 years to get my nursing degree. Not just saying I was slacking, it's just I have kids. And they slow you down just a tad bit, but I keep moving. So now I'm currently in school for law, and I have 2 years left. So for the ones that, you know, feels like I just can't do it, or whatever excuse that you may have, it's not real. And I can't is not anybody's vocabulary. So you got it.
Well done. Hey, she said it all, man. I think that is a great way to capitalize on a episode. I love the fact that you're through, and I won't even call it a struggle, through your journey, you're clinging to different motivational quotes. You're obviously being optimistic and keeping your head up, like you just said, and you're not letting your situation determine the outcome. Like, I admire people that can tap into that, because a lot of people, honestly, you know, situations can defeat you, you know, and really halt that process in your in whatever journey that you decide to take. But it sounds like you are on the right path.
And
you said so you got 2 more years in law school?
Yeah.
Turn me up.
I've been busy. I don't be having no time for friends. Hey, listen, but I try to.
The thing is, it's all gonna pay off, because when it's all said and done, you gonna have, like you said, you didn't get it in the time frame that you necessarily wanted to, but you're still taking care of it. So can't do nothing but respect and be proud of a person that's doing that. So yay to you. Kudos to you. But shoot, was there anything else you wanted to say?
Well, I think
we're
good.
Cool. Guys, well, this is another one. Man, this was dope. This is another episode of the Not Your Average Success Story Movement on season. Thank you guys for supporting the Not Your Average Success Story Movement. I really hope that you enjoyed the episode. There was a lot of time, energy, and effort spent with making this a successful moment, not only for the guest, but for myself and everybody else. And I hope that you enjoyed the episode as much as I did, and look forward to another beautiful episode next week on the Not Your Average Success Story platform. Thank you again, because this movement would not be successful without you and your support. So big thank you from the bottom of my heart. Please continue to support. Also, subscribe. So, thank you guys. Peace, love, and chicken grease.